USDJPY. Actually, there is not much to say about the USDJPY because the market is still struggling right on this support, right on this resistance zone. We are still not able to break through from this resistance zone. However, I have given so many signals that the USDJPY should actually start falling after reversing on this resistance trend line. And even we saw here a price action indicating a reversal. However, sadly for the whole week, the market was just ranging on this level. Now, what I'm seeing here is a full bar candle, full bar here, full green bar, followed by another red bar here. That price action usually indicating that there will be a continuation of the bearish momentum. And let me just use Fibonacci this time just to decide what is the right thing to do with the USDJPY. And as you can see, the Fibonacci level is on 61.8. And as you guys know already, if the market will break from 61.8, it means a change in the direction of the market. However, so far the USDJPY was not able to break from this resistance trend line, and we can see that there were so many attempts on this resistance. The market on the USDJPY is moving very, very slowly. We need to find out what is the next thing to do. Let's go now to the 4-hour chart. Now, 4-hour chart, we can see that there was a reversal right on this previous support level. We can see here the market reversed on the support and here and right here. Now, the question is, do you think the reversal on this support is gonna last for a long time? The answer is absolutely not. Let me now use some trend lines just to be sure where can we expect the next reversal and where we can expect for the USDJPY to actually continue falling more down. So using the trend line right here on this previous resistance trend line, like that and like here, which was also a strong support trend line here. Anyway, this is indicating that the market actually it already hit this resistance trend line, and therefore we can expect for the USDJPY to continue its bearish momentum, not for so long. I think it's gonna just reverse right on the support level. Let me just be more clear, because the USDJPY is ranging a lot, and it's actually quite hard to give or to expect what's gonna happen next. In my opinion, USDJPY is going to go up here, hitting this previous resistance trend line, and then going to fall down. However, that is not what's gonna happen in my expectation on Monday or even Tuesday. This level of the support level, let me just draw it for you. This level right here of the support, I believe it's gonna be retested again, and USDJPY, I'm expecting for it, because right now it's on this resistance level. I think USDJPY is gonna continue falling more down, reversing and respecting this resistance level, going all the way down, hitting this previous support level, and then it's going to make a final pullback, hitting this resistance trend line, and then it's gonna continue falling more down. We have been expecting this to happen for so many long time actually on the USDJPY. Please everyone, you have to be very careful when you are trading the USDJPY. Is ranging a lot. That's why this week analysis is on the smaller time frame on the 4-hour chart. And you know something, let me move to the 1-hour chart. As I told you, look at that. On the 1-hour chart, we can see that the pair is currently on a resistance level right here and right here and right here. As I told you exactly, we can expect for the reversal to happen, go down here, hitting this previous support, and then gonna go up, and then gonna again reverse. So seeing the 1-hour chart has confirmed to me that my expectation hopefully is gonna be accurate, and that's my expectation for the USDJPY. Hopefully we're going to make it, and it's gonna be profitable. And again, thank you guys for your time and for watching.